You're listening to Empire State College here on Comm Radio.
New York, down he goes. It's Beckham getting loose, and he's going to take it the distance.
New York City. New York, New York.
Cross-court Jennings up top, Porzingis puts it in. Kristaps Porzingis from downtown. He's got 35, and the Knicks back up by 11.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Empire State College, your premier New York sports destination here at Penn State. I'm Christian Kouroupakis, joined always by Charlie Hart, back from spring break. Charlie, what's happening?
What's happening, man? We got some March Madness here in the studio. Got some great games going on. We have Vanderbilt down one with 40 seconds left, and they take the lead. But let's talk some New York sports.
Let's just do the play-by-play from the TV we're watching. Can't get into March Madness. Yeah. Never was able to get into it.
Yeah, well, you're not a basketball fan, so.
Yeah, you know me. I'm just a baseball all the way.
Yep.
But I'm happy Giants fan right now.
That was a very, very good transition.
My boys picked up your boy, Brandon Marshall, after you said... He's not even leaving the Jets.
1 hour later. 1 hour later, he was released from the Jets. That was heartbreaking.
That was funny.
Not really.
For those who aren't aware, we were talking about the Jets making cuts our last show, which was 2 weeks ago. It was right after they cut Revis, right? And they cut Mangold. And I brought up Brandon Marshall. I said, do you think Brandon Marshall's going? Charlie was emphatic about it. He said, no way. It's not happening. And literally an hour after, he was cut. And 2 days or whatever it was after that, he got picked up by the Giants. I'm a happy man.
Should be.
Very happy man.
You should be.
Look at that receiving corpse. I just found out that it's not core. It's corpse. But Odell Beckham, Sterling Shepard, Brandon Marshall. He's going to be the second guy, obviously.
Who, right? Marshall?
Marshall.
Yeah,
yeah, he's got to be the second guy. Oh, dude, that's scary.
It is.
Nightmare-inducing is what I like to say.
But then you remember who's throwing the ball.
Oh, come on.
Mr. Eli Manning.
What about it? Be respectful. I'll go Stephen A. on you.
No, listen. Eli's a good quarterback. He's average. He's not elite like everyone says he is. I hate that word elite. But, I mean, listen. You have Brandon Marshall, Odell Beckham Jr., Sterling Shepard.
Yes.
You don't need Aaron Rodgers throwing them the ball. They can make plays on the quarterback. Brandon Marshall made Ryan Fitzpatrick
I was about to bring that up.
Look like... not a good quarterback. A mediocre quarterback.
Yeah, which for Ryan Fitzpatrick, that's being
yes.
very generous.
Yes. So you guys got a steal. I am still very bitter about it. But I will say this. Brandon Marshall last year did not play all that well.
He was dealing with that knee, though.
Exactly. Some of that was injury. Some of that was Ryan Fitzpatrick, Bryce Petty. But let me just run off the stats real quick. Brandon Marshall last year only had 788 yards in 16 games.
He played 16 games?
And maybe 14 games.
Okay.
I don't have it on here, but I think it was
okay.
14 games, actually. Quincy Enunwa in 16 games, 857 yards. So, as you said, I mean, Enunwa...
But now he's number two, so we can't be talking like he's the elite wide receiver he is.
Well, the thing is, he was the number one last year.
Yeah, but now he's coming... like. I'm just trying to transition it because he's now the Giants' number two. So I still think he's going to be a dynamic wideout in the Giants' offense now that he's number two instead of number one.
Listen, you just have to remember you're not getting the same Brandon Marshall as you were
But you're
years
also not getting the same coverage that you're getting on Brandon Marshall.
Yeah, I mean, listen, the thing is, you look at these numbers. He was the 67th ranked wide receiver in the NFL.
Based on what? Receiving yards?
According to Pro Football Focus.
Oh, that's a rating they do.
Numbers,
oh,
but,
they do like a whole formulation. Ooh, Northwestern just took a lead on your
as
your boys.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus is cheering on Northwestern. this is a fun time. Very fun
We're very loose here. Today. We just hopped from Brandon Marshall to March Madness.
Yeah, but back to Brandon Marshall. listen, he's going to fit into the – he'll fit into any offense.
Yeah, he'll be fine.
I do think this – listen, I'm a Jet fan. I have no stake in the Giants at all. This does make them a Super Bowl contender. I will say, with that defense, you needed one more wide receiver. You do need a running back still, but maybe Perkins can take the reins over there. He has a lot of potential. I just don't know if he's a every down back.
Well, he was explosive last year when he was given the chance. So.
Yeah. Do you know off the top of your head his yards per carry and all that?
No. I could tell you how many intentional walks happened last year compared to years prior, but I can't tell you how many rushing yards Paul Perkins had. But I look at the Giants. You mentioned Super Bowl favorites. If they just picked up DJ Fluker, if he works out, book it right now. The Giants are coming out of the NFC.
That's a bit of a overstatement.
Not an overstatement.
Don't get too excited.
A lot of people called me crazy last year when I predicted the Giants were going 11-5 in preseason. A lot of people called me crazy. It happened. Giants are coming. If DJ Fluker works out, the Giants are coming out of the NFC.
They still have a lot of O-line problems.
Okay.
DJ Fluker isn't going to solve the entire line.
I'll stand by it, though. You add another weapon into there. They just picked up. They just need a dynamic tight end. I think they picked up a guy, but I don't remember. I'm not following the Giants. I'm all in Yankees mode right now, so I'm not really following who the Giants are picking up. But you throw Brandon Marshall into the mix, and Eli is going to have a fun time.
The thing with the Giants is if you have such a poor offensive line, you need to get the ball out quickly. And you can do that now with all these weapons. This makes their offense so much more versatile.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun to watch.
It's going to be a fun Giants team. I'm excited. And Bovada? Is that the betting company? Is that pronounced right?
Nevada?
No, but it's a betting company.
No. Anyway, I don't bet. Don't boat. Don't bet.
Their odds to win the Super Bowl has jumped to 15 to 1. That's sixth best in the NFL. Really doesn't mean much to
us. We don't condone betting on this program.
Nor do we condone assault by Darrell Revis.
Yeah. Hey, he got cleared.
But yeah, the running game should improve with Perkins. I think it'll be very fun to watch with Perkins a full season with him as number one back. Receiving corps is a nightmare-inducing. DJ Fluker works out. I'm telling you right now. NFC champs.
That's a hot take.
Hot take, and it happened right here. We're going to take our first commercial break. We're going to come back with some Yankees talk and World Baseball Classic. I want to bring that up, too. So we'll be right back here on Empire State College.
You are listening to Empire State College here on Comm Radio.
Stronger Lions pride, stand together, blue and white. Lions pride, show the world your Penn State side. Lions pride, you're living, you're loving Lions pride. Oh, reach higher, Lions pride. Lions pride, show the world your Penn State side. Lions pride, you're living, you're loving Lions pride.
Looking for an easier way to listen to Comm Radio than streaming on your computer? With Comm Radio's phone app for both iOS and Android devices, you can tune into Comm Radio on your phone anytime, anywhere. Just visit the App Store on your device and search for Penn State Comm Radio to download our free application, which allows you to stream over cellular data or Wi-Fi connection. Don't miss the easiest way to catch all your favorite Penn State sports, news, or talk shows, and download the Comm Radio app today.
You're listening to Empire State College here on Comm Radio.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York, these vagabond shoes.
Welcome back, everybody, to Empire State College, talking New York sports here on Comm Radio. I'm Christian Kouroupakis, joined always by Charlie Hart. We just talked about Brandon Marshall, got interrupted by some March Madness. Giants, I just picked them as my NFC favorites, champs, actually. So we've got some hot takes, we've got some analyst stuff going down here. I don't even know if that's a word, but whatever. We're going to hop over to spring training now. I'm all in on Yankees spring training, following them pretty aggressively. Charlie, do you have anything you've been watching out for spring training? Have you been following it really religiously?
Not so much. I know the meat of our order, they have extremely high batting averages, I saw.
I mean, results aren't really at all in spring at all. Like, they don't mean anything at all at spring training.
Oh, yeah.
But what I love is just how they're looking at the plate.
Exactly.
Judge was being aggressive at the plate. Greg Bird looks sweet. His swing looks great. Gary Sanchez is doing Gary Sanchez things. Did you see his bat flip yesterday?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it was epic. It was a single, but I love the bat flip.
Yeah.
It was sick.
Like I said, I mean, I watch a lot of these highlights, and these young studs, man, I'm not saying they're going to carry us to a division, you know, championship or anything like that, but if they continue to rake like this, as you know, you wrote an article a couple months ago talking about how if the Yankees hit, you know, historically, if the Yankees hit a bunch of home runs, they always make the playoffs.
Last 17 years, they hit 200 or more home runs in 13 seasons, made the postseason all those 13. In the four they didn't make the postseason.
Exactly. So you look at Judge, mm-hmm. Bird, Sanchez, Chris Carter maybe.
Yeah.
They have so much power in this lineup. Yeah. So that's just my takeaway out of spring training so far.
It's definitely, the vibe is the kids are all right.
There's that's a lot of optimism.
This is the kind of vibe we're getting, especially when they have the most wins, they're scoring the most runs, their ERA is the lowest. When you're successful, no matter when it is, people are getting optimistic, and that's kind of where the Yankees are at. I'm looking at it, I love the lineup. What I'm looking at more specifically is the starting pitching, which no one has really separated themselves from the pack. Sesa today got lit up. Kaprielan came in. He pitched well. He got 3 strikeouts in his 2 innings. Sat at the 96-mile-an-hour range, but he's not cracking camp. He's actually sent down today. So other than that, Green, Sesa, they're struggling with command. Green can't relocate his fastball. Warren, I've advocated from the beginning, Warren needs to be in the bullpen no matter what. I don't care if he's lighting it up as a starter. His role in the bullpen is more valuable than a fifth starter. So that's my take on Warren. Severino, while he's figured out his changeup, you said it off the air, there's always something, and his fastball isn't there. So, and Mitchell's been pressed. Mitchell's probably been by far the best. He's sitting at 97. His fastball looks pretty good. So Mitchell looks great. He deserves a spot if I had to pick right now. But other than Mitchell, I can't really put my finger on anyone who's separating themselves and deserve a spot. Therefore, I make the case. Second hot take of the show. The Yankees should sign Jason Marquis. The Israel's ace in the WBC.
Are we sure it's Marquis?
Marquis. I've been saying Marquis all week, so going by Marquis. And whoever is a Team Israel fan and wants to yell at me, go ahead. So I made the case this week, but the Yankees could and probably should look elsewhere because no one really else is stepping up. Jose Quintana has been the rumor that never dies, but I don't think it's happening right now. So I'm going with a low-risk, high-reward signing in someone like Jason Marquis. And what he's doing with Team Israel certainly warrants a look. Listen to this. 3 starts, Marquis owns 0.93 ERA over 9 2/3 innings of work, only allowed 1 run on a home run. And he spent the last year and a half at home in New York working out with weighted balls. He's 38, so he's up there. Made mechanical adjustments during the frequent throwing sessions and claims he's back to the weight he was at 22. I'll ask you this. If the Yankees aren't confident with Severino, Sesa, or Green for the last spot, should the Yankees take a low-risk move like this?
Of course. If he has those numbers, of course.
Yeah. These are the best in the world he's shutting down.
Now, how many starts is...
3 starts.
3 starts.
I think he's due for another start. I don't know when Tim Israel plays next. I'll look that up right now, but yeah.
Was he he was a Philly, correct?
He jumped around.
Okay.
He played for a bunch of teams. I know he played for the Reds. I know he appeared in seven postseason games, I think he appeared in. He played in a World Series. I know the Reds. The other teams are blanking on me.
Yeah. Again, I don't have his numbers off the top of my head. feel like Mike Francesa of the Yes Network. I don't know if you saw that. Spent 3 minutes of a show today just looking up Maryland versus Florida State to find out that they're not in the same conference.
Oh, boy.
But, yeah, like I said, I don't know his numbers. It seems he's bounced around, and usually that's a bad sign. Not to say he can't be salvaged, but, at again, 38
years old.
There probably might not be too much there, but if he's pitching like this against world-class, you know, baseball players,
yeah,
why not?
My methodology is, or my thinking in this is, why not? If you're not going to be able to trust, because I think if you throw Severino in the rotation to start the year, he's not only going to get lit up, but his confidence is going to go way down. Same thing with Sesa. He doesn't look good at all. I said Warren should be in the bullpen.
Mitchell's
good. He's got the fourth spot in right now. It's two spots.
It's Cece.
It's Tanaka,
Pineda,
Mitchell,
right.
And then one more spot.
Yeah. Okay.
So if I don't trust anyone, and I think it's going to hurt the development, which I think it will, why not?
Yeah.
There's a couple more options out there, but yeah, they just gave Ernesto Fieri a 1-year contract for the middle, to help the middle relief out. Minor league deal, invitation to camp, could be in the major leagues at some point to help out the middle relief unit. Why not do the same thing for starting pitching? They didn't address the problem in the offseason. They should have. If they want to contend, which they want to, listen to this. 22 starts last season made by starters that weren't even part of the rotation to begin the season. If you think they don't want anyone to help stabilize the rotation and they're not seeing that in camp, you crazy.
What was that?
I don't know. You crazy is what I want to do. So we're a little... We have to take another commercial break, so we're going to do that right now. And we'll be right back here on Empire State College.
You are listening to Empire State College here on Comm Radio.
This song doesn't get your juices flowing, then maybe this will.
Castle up with it there. Fed one around in front. Haglund, your shot. It's over!
The Penguins winning the Stanley Cup last year.